For many, how you use and navigate your app can be classified in one of two ways, either browsing through content or by directed search for specific content. If your app isn't delivering a good in-app search experience, you're only serving part of your user base. Hi, I'm Ian Lake, and I want to show you what goes into building a great in-app search experience using SearchView to help your users get to exactly what they want as easily as possible. The basic building blocks of a good search experience start with perhaps the hardest one. Good content. We're talking about searching using a single query string, but how that maps onto your data, be it a list of users or a full text search of posts, and how you store that data is all in your hands. Although it may be helpful to have a special full text search or FTS table locally on the device if your data set is small enough and query speed is critical. For now, let's focus on the search process itself. With search being such a core navigation pattern, it makes sense to standardize on a single pattern for providing search. For Android, that involves an aptly named search view. Usually the search view is seen as an action in the main app bar or an appropriate toolbar. By tapping on the search view icon, the search view expands in line, allowing users to immediately search. Through AppCompat, part of the Android support library, search view is available on all Android 2.1 and higher devices. Adding a search view to your app bar involves just adding another item to the menu you inflate. Besides the more obvious title and icon, you'll note the Show as Action contains Collapse Action View. This is what tells the menu that this item should be collapsed by default, but can be expanded into the full Action View class that's defined. We also need If Room, or alternatively, Always, for Show as Action. Without this, our icon will only appear in the overflow menu and we won't be able to expand it into the full search view. Not what we want. With just this addition, we get a nice search icon that expands into the search view, but search doesn't really go anywhere or do anything. We can get a reference to it when we inflate our menu, but where do we go from there? Firstly, there's full manual mode using Set On Query Text Listener. Here, you'll get a callback for when the search text changes and when the user submits their search, giving you full control over exactly what happens when. But you can take advantage of a lot more when you instead provide a searchable configuration. This is an XML file specifically for all the various options relating to search. So many options that we have a full documentation page just on all the various options, all 9 pages of the detailed explanations. Thankfully, it can also be super short and easy. Just a label, which should usually be your app name, and a hint in the form of search posts or search your app name. Guess what it takes to add voice search to your search view? Just a single additional line to your searchable configuration. That's a pretty powerful line, but remember that voice search directly submits what is said. There's no opportunity to change things before submitting, so make sure your searches lend themselves to voice before enabling it. Then you'll associate that searchable configuration with an activity. This is the activity you want to go to when the user submits a query. You'll note we use single top launch mode. This is important if you have a search view on your searchable activity, say to do a second search. And this launch mode prevents a potential giant backstack of search result screens. Hooking up your search view to a searchable configuration uses Search Manager, the system service which parses that metadata element you've added to one of your activities and creates a searchable info you can pass to your search view. This launches our searchable activity, but to extract the actual search text, we look for action search and then extract the query from the intents extra. You call this from onCreate, and if you are using that single top launch mode, call it from onNewIntent as well. We have a great looking search view that directly searches to the activity of our choice. What we haven't talked about yet are recent query suggestions or custom suggestions, which make things even easier for users to find what they want. Check out the developer site for more information. I can't wait to see what awesome experiences you come up with using in-app search on your quest to build better apps.